हेलो स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स दिस इज़ योर फिजिक्स क्लास। सो आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर रिलेटेड टू स्फेरिकल लेंस विच इज़ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ स्फेरिकल लेंस। सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी रेड अबाउट टू टाइप ऑफ स्फेरिकल लेंस। फर्स्ट इज़ कनकेव लेंस and second one is convex lens. So convex lens also known as converging lens, because in case of convex lens the ray of light when parallel to principal axis after refraction it converges toward the principal axis or converges at a point. So similarly, in case of concave lens, when ray of light traveling toward the lens and parallel to principal axis, the given lens, concave lens, diverges the ray of light. So students, today we are going to study about how a image formed by these lens. First of all, we study about how to be image formed in convex lens. So I'm going to share a video. First of all, look at the video carefully and understand the given points on your write as a keyword some point which is related to image formation. After that you assemble all points in your notes. So ready for a video?
As for image formation by a convex lens. Hello students, we know that when we place an object such as a cattle in front of a convex lens at different positions, images of different sizes and nature are formed. So we can say that the position, nature and size of the image formed by a convex lens depend on the position of the object placed in front of it. In this video, we will learn how to draw ray diagrams to represent the formation of images by a convex lens, which will help us determine the position and the characteristics of the image formed. In a ray diagram, we trace the path of the rays from an object that are incident on the lens. We know that there are infinite rays from an object that are incident on the lens. It can be difficult to trace the path of the rays after they are refracted by a lens, as we would have to find the exact angle of incidence and angle of refraction for each of them. In order to simplify this process, we choose rays that follow a predictable path after refraction. The first incident ray that we can consider is the ray that is parallel to the principal axis of a convex lens. After refracting from the lens, this ray will pass through the principal focus F2 on the other side of the lens. The second ray that we can consider is the one passing through the principal focus F1 of the convex lens. This ray will emerge parallel to the principal axis after refraction from the lens. The third ray that we can consider is the one passing through the optical center O of the lens. This ray will emerge without any deviation. To draw ray diagrams for a convex lens, we can consider any two of these three incident rays. Now, let's begin with the steps to draw the ray diagrams. The first step is to draw a convex lens and mark its optical center O. Then we will draw its principal axis which passes through the optical center O. Next, using a ruler, we will mark the points F1 and F2 at equal distances from O on either side of the lens. Then we will mark 2F1 and 2F2 at the same distance as taken earlier from F1 and F2 respectively. We need to make sure that the four line segments are equal. Let's take an example of an object that is placed beyond 2F1 in front of the convex lens. It is represented by an upward pointing arrow. We will label the tip of the object as A and the base of the object as B. Next, let's choose any two suitable incident rays from the tip of the object and draw their corresponding refracted rays. Let's consider an incident ray parallel to the principal axis, which will pass through F2 after refraction from the lens. Next, draw another incident ray passing through the optical center O, which will emerge without any deviation after refraction. Notice that both the refracted rays intersect below the principal axis. This point of intersection represents the tip of the image. Now, let's draw an arrow to represent the image. Since the object is placed on the principal axis, the base of the image will also be on the principal axis. The tip of the arrow will be at the point where the refracted rays meet or seem to meet. Mark the endpoints of the image as A' and B'. Finally, we will note the position and characteristics of the image. Here, the image is formed between F2 and 2F2 and it is real, inverted and diminished. So, this is how we can draw ray diagrams for an object placed in different positions in front of a convex lens with its base on the principal axis. We can do so by choosing any two incident rays from the object and tracing their path. Thank you. Happy learning.
So students, in this video, you understand about image formation by a convex lens. So we are going to read about image formation with a given step. So first step, how do we draw a ray diagram similarly as a which is mentioned or which is played in a video, same as this in a written form, how do we form an image by a convex lens? So first step, draw a convex lens like that and draw a principal axis through a O point, which is optical center, and mark F1 and F2 means focus 1 and focus 2. So second step, draw the object on principal axis. The object is AB, which is beyond 2F1. So label the end of the object AB like arrow represent an object which is beyond center 1 or 2F1. So next step, we take at least two incident rays. So incident rays which fall on a optical or lens. So two rays which starting from top toward the lens, which is parallel to principal axis, and another one is toward the optical center. So we take at least two incident rays. So after that, in a fourth step, the incident ray after refracted, which passed through the lens, after conversion of the ray of light by convex lens, so one ray which is parallel to principal axis pass through the focus and another is following same path which is passed through the optical center. So after interaction, where two rays are intersect means that is intersecting point. There are two rays, refracted rays were intersecting. At that point, image is formed. So like that, the image is formed which is real and inverted. Real image, that's why, because after converging or after refracted, these refracted ray intersect actually and image is inverted. So in between F2 means focus 2 and center 2, the image is formed, A dash B dash. So student, there are 6 another image formation by a convex lens is also given in your NCERT book and your supplementary book. So according to these steps, we form image on a different position according to principal axis. For example, when object placed at infinity, so how do we image formed when object placed at infinity? So in this case, we form image, we take a 2 incident ray which is parallel to principal axis and after reflection pass through the focus. That means the image formed on a focus as a point size. So similarly, another image when object placed beyond the center 1. So how do we form an image? One ray which is parallel to principal axis, another ray, second incident ray, which pass through the optical center and after reflection the principal axis parallel ray pass through the focus and another ray follow the straight path. So in this case, the image formed in between focus 2 and center 2. So similarly, 6 another image formed similarly after following these steps. We take at least 2 incident ray. So students, if you have any problem related to image formation by a convex lens, you text me in my personal window on WhatsApp and you have to practice question number 7 on your SB19, which is related to image formation by a convex lens. So these are the image which related to image formation. So there are 6 type of image formation you have to do with yourself on your rough notebook. After that, you prepare your notes neat and clean, and it is important you have to draw image formation by pencil, not use a pen on your fair notebook. Thank you student. If you have any problem related to these topic, so take your queries on your WhatsApp or call me anytime. Thank you.